there, film fans, and welcome back to Movies with Maddie. Today we're going to be talking about the movie Stuber, starring Kumail Nanjiani and Dave Bautista. Now, normally I'm not a fan of buddy comedy movies, cop movies, or raunchy movies.
My name is Jeff.
Partially due to the fact that I enjoy a little drier, more cynical comedy. But to be fair, Kumail Nanjiani definitely offers that. Anyone remember The Big Sick? Not the rom-com we wanted, but the kind of cute, kind of cringy dramedy we needed. So, let me break this down for you. We start off with a quirky Uber driver and a cop with an appetite for revenge. Both characters obviously have some baggage. Stu, the Uber driver, is in the middle of that classic, I love my best friend, but she kind of doesn't think of me in that way and she's taken, so I'm gonna invest in a female gym with her. Dilemma. It's pretty sad. Then there's Vic Manning, tough street cop whose partner has recently been killed by the notorious criminal, Oka Tedjo. Vic has been hunting down Tedjo for ages, until his daughter persuades him to take a little break and a little time for himself since he has to schedule a LASIK eye surgery. As a result, Vic is told that he won't be able to fully recover his vision until a day or two after the surgery. That same surgery that he scheduled on the day of his daughter's art show. Yeah, just father of the year right there. And there's plenty more of that kind of disappointment by Vic, which Stu calls him out for, saying that he's a terrible father, a terrible friend, and he's way too focused on being macho and emotionally closed off. But honestly, Vic's daughter, Nicole, played by Natalie Morales, handles it like a champ. She plays the character as a very strong, capable daughter with just enough sass and creativity to make her interesting. Going on to the action, the plot is kind of everywhere. Throughout their adventure, Vic and Stu, Vic's new Uber driver, end up in a warehouse, a male strip club. Warning, there will be penises. Many, many over-proportioned penises.
I don't have a penis.
In Compton, where Stu accidentally shoots someone and is forced to stick along for the ride. No pun intended. A veterinary clinic, Nicole's art gallery, the sporting goods store that Stu works at, and finally, a hot sauce factory.
Spicy!
Yet even with all of these locations and predicaments and casualties, the movie does not feel very fast-paced. In fact, and I know I'm not alone here, the only thing I really liked was the chemistry going on between Nanjiani and Bautista, as well as some of the fight scene choreography and Nanjiani's comic relief. You guys, he's just very awkward and deadpan and dry, and that's just my kind of person right there. But the plot does really seem predictably unpredictable, a little cringy, and kind of forced at times. Let me just give a very strong spoiler alert here so that nobody hates me.
Spoilers!
In the end, the real villain behind everything was really a dirty cop that had known Vic for years. And Stu doesn't end up getting the girl being Becca. You know, the one that he invested in the weird gym thing with. Basically the entire movie he's trying to get back to her because she just broke up with her boyfriend and kept saying, while getting more and more drunk, originally said, hey, let's hang out, I might need some help, you know, getting over this. And then towards the end, she's like, you know what would be great? We should totally get together.
Let's get physical.
So that's a side plot thing. So he doesn't get Becca, but he does get a different girl. And that might be the only real surprising thing there. And the girl is Vic's daughter. It's pretty cute. It honestly seems like a ripoff of Central Intelligence. You remember Central Intelligence, right? It had Dwayne The Rock Johnson, had Kevin Hart. It was released in, you know, early summer of 2016. That's when I worked at a movie theater, so I definitely saw it two or three times because it was free. And coincidentally, the script for this movie was actually bought roughly 1 or 2 months before the release of Central Intelligence. Anyways, the other funny thing is that this movie is getting released right around the time when Uber just released its new quiet feature for people that, you know, want to ride in a car and stare at their phone and not have to make casual or forced small talk with their driver. Yep. Which Stu definitely does a lot of. He's pretty thirsty for that 5-star review, so he's very very cringy.
Hey! Uber?
Yeah. My God. Hey, let me guess, you want me to drive you to all the Sarah Connors in the city?
Come on, start it up, let's go.
Oh, it's already started. Electric car. I call it silent but deadly.
Drive.
I'm Stu. How do you do? Can I get you some bottled water, some Canadian chocolates? It was one of those things where I thought I was getting 5 bars on Amazon, but I ended up getting
Koreatown, now.
Koreatown? Now. Hold on, I'm gonna bang a Yui here real quick. Nope, don't got it. Hold on. Oh, didn't quite make it. Just a couple more points and we got it.
I would recommend this movie if you're bored, if you have a lot of friends that are easily amused, or if you just want to see a movie that you don't really have to pay attention to, but that has a couple of good laughs in it along the way. Well, that's all from me. Bye!